Hello friends, welcome to our channel Vidyanamastu. By saying learn what you love and love what you learn. We'll start with our video.
Today, let us begin with the chapter called polynomial. Recalling what we have studied in 9th standard, the definition of polynomial says that it is an expression which consists of variables and coefficients with addition, subtraction and multiplication operations performed. Now, let us begin with the exercise 2.1. The question number 1 says that the graph of y is equal to p of x are given in the following figure for some polynomials p of x. Find the number of zeros of p of x in each case. Now, let us see the first graph. By saying the first graph y is equal to p of x, the line does not touch the x-axis at any point. So, the number of zeros is 0. Now let us go to the second graph. So in second graph, the curve cuts the x-axis at only one point. Therefore, the number of zeros is 1. In third graph, the curve cuts the x-axis at 3 different points. One on the negative x-axis and 2 points on the positive x-axis. So therefore, the number of zeros is 3. So in the fourth graph, the curve cuts the x-axis at 2 different points, both on the negative x-axis. Therefore, the total number of zeros is 2. In the fifth graph, the curve y is equal to p of x cuts the x-axis at 4 different points, 2 on the negative x-axis and 2 on the positive x-axis. Therefore, total number of zeros is 4. So the last graph, sixth one, the curve y is equal to p of x cuts the x-axis at 3 different points, 2 on the negative x-axis and 1 on the positive x-axis. Therefore, the total number of zeros is 3.
Now, moving on to the second exercise, first question they have given to find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomials and verify the relationship between the zeros and its coefficients. So in that, the first question is given as x square minus 2x minus 8. So solving this, the quadratic equation is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c, where a equal to 1, b equal to minus 2 and c equal to minus 8. Now, on factorizing the above equation by splitting up of middle term, we will get as x square minus 4x plus 2x minus 8. So taking common terms in these two, we will get x as a common term. So the leftover is x inside the bracket and here minus 4 plus taking common terms in these two, we will get 2 as a common term. And the leftover is x minus 4. In these two, x minus 4 and we will get x minus x plus 2. Therefore, x is equal to x minus 4 equal to 0 and x plus 2 equal to 0 are the zeros of the polynomial, and hence we will get x equal to 4 and x equal to minus 2. Therefore, x equal to 4 and x equal to minus 2 are the zeros of the polynomial x square minus 2x minus 8. So they have asked us to verify the relationship between the zeros and its coefficient. So let alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial. So the relationship is given as the sum of the zeros, that is alpha plus beta, is defined as the ratio of minus of coefficient of x and coefficient of x square. So this coefficient of x in this is minus b, okay, minus of b, coefficient of x is b divided by coefficient of x square is a. Okay, now alpha plus beta, we can write it as minus b by a. B is minus 2, minus of b is minus 2, minus of minus 2 divided by a. A we have as 1, so this can be written as 2 itself. So to verify this, alpha we have as 4 and beta we have as minus 2. So alpha is 4 plus beta is minus 2. We will get as 4 minus 2 itself, which is equal to 2. So we got both as same, hence verified. And another relationship is given as alpha into beta is equal to the ratio of constant term divided by coefficient of x square of x square. So what is the coefficient of constant term is c and coefficient of x square is a. So alpha into beta is defined as c by a. So alpha into beta equal to c we have as minus 8 and a as 1, which is equal to minus 8 itself. So to verify this, alpha we have got as 4 and beta we have got as minus 2. So substituting that, 4 into minus 2, we will get it as minus 8 itself. Therefore we got both as same, hence verified. Now moving on to the second question, in that it is given as 4s square minus 4s plus 1. So here they have changed the variable as s. Variable can be anything, x, y, z, u, t, etc. So to get the solution for this, this expression is in the form of as square minus bs plus c. So where a equal to 4, as square plus bs plus c, b equal to minus 4 and c equal to 1. Now, to solve this by factorization method, by splitting up the middle term, we will get it as 4s square minus 2s minus 2s plus 1. So, taking common terms in these two, we will get 2s as common, and the leftover is 2s minus 1. And minus 1 in this 2 common term is minus 1, so we'll get the same as 2s minus 1 inside this bracket. So in this 2, 2s minus 1 into 2s minus 1. To find the zeros of the polynomial, this 2s minus 1 equal to 0, and similarly 2s minus 1 equal to 0. So 2s will become equal to 1, and this s will become 1 by 2. Similarly, this s also will become 1 by 2. Therefore, the zeros of the expression 4s square minus 4s plus 1 is 1 by 2 and 1 by 2. So to verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients, we have alpha plus beta. So it is similar to that of the previous problem what we have solved. So alpha plus beta we had got as minus b by a, right? So here also it will remain same. So what is b here? This directly will substitute here. Minus b we are substituting as minus 4, b is minus 4 divided by a we had got as 4 minus 4, minus of minus 4 by 4, minus of minus is plus, therefore we can write it as 4 by 4 itself, which is equal to 1. So and to verify this, alpha is 1 by 2 and beta is 1 by 2. So adding these two, alpha plus half plus half, we'll get it as 1 itself. So in both the methods we got as 1, and hence it is verified. So another expression, another representation is given by alpha into beta equal to c by a. Now from the above, c is 1 and a is 4. To verify this, we have got alpha as 1 by 2 and beta as 1 by 2. So multiplying half into half, we will get it as 1 by 4. So here also in both methods we get 1 by 4 and 1 by 4, and hence it is verified. Moving on to the third question, we have 6x square minus 3 minus 7x. So this is also in the form of ax square plus bx plus c, where a equal to 6, b equal to minus 3, and c equal to, sorry, here b we have minus 7, and c we have minus 3. So before getting confused, rearrange it in the form 6x square minus 7x minus 3. So now no confusion. Now solving this expression by factorization method, we will get it as 6x square minus 9x plus 2x minus 3. So taking common term in these two, we have 3x as a common term, and in the bracket we will get it as 2x minus 3 plus, take common in these two, we have 1 as a common term, and now we will get as 2x minus 3 itself. So solving this, 2x minus 3 into 3x plus 1. So to find the zeros of the polynomial, we have 2x minus 3 equal to 0 and 3x plus 1 is also equal to 0. So from this we will get 2x is equal to 3, and from this here we will get 3x equal to minus 1. Here x we can find it out and we can write it as 3 by 2. Here we will get x equal to minus 1 by 3. Therefore minus 3 by 2 and minus 1 by 3 are the zeros of the polynomial 6x square minus 7x minus 3. And to verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients, we have alpha plus beta, which is equal to minus b by a. So here b we have minus 7, so minus of minus 7, a we have got as 6. So a is 6, therefore we will get it as 7 by 6. To verify this, the two zeros are alpha and beta. Alpha is 3 by 2 and beta we have got as minus 1 by 3. So alpha is 3 by 2 minus 1 by 3. Here also we will get as LCM, here we will get LCM as 6, here 2 into 3 is 6, so multiply numerator and denominator by 3, so here we will get it as 9, here 3 into 2 is 6, so multiply numerator and denominator by 2 and 2, so now we will get numerator as 2 itself, minus 2. So 9 minus 2 is 7, denominator 6. Therefore these two are same and hence it is verified. And one more representation is alpha into beta. Alpha into beta we have C by A. Now what is C? C is minus 3 and A we have got as 6. Now to verify this, alpha we have 3 by 2 and beta we have minus 1 by 3. So multiplying this alpha and beta, we will get 3 by 2 into minus 1 by 3, we will get 3 into minus 1 is minus 3, 2 into 3 is 6. Hence, we will get both of this as same. Hence, verified. Moving on to the fourth question, we have 4u square plus 8u. So, how do you solve this? So this also expression is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c, where a equal to 4, b equal to 8 and c equal to 0. So solving this is very simple. We have 4u square plus 8u, right? Plus 0. Okay. Taking common in these two, we have 4u as common. So 4u as common, and inside the bracket we will get it as u and plus 2. Okay. Now, to find the zeros of the polynomial, 4u should be equal to 0 and u plus 2 also should be equal to 0. So directly from this we will get u equal to 0 and from this expression we will get u equal to minus Therefore, u equal to 0 and u equal to minus 2 are the zeros of the polynomial 4u square plus 8u. Now, to verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients, we have alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. B we have 8, so minus 8 by 4. 8 by 4 is 2 and minus sign as it is. We will get it as minus 2. So to verify this, we have got alpha equal to 0 and beta equal to minus 2. Therefore, adding these two, alpha is 0 and beta we have minus 2. So plus and minus is minus, we will get it as minus 2 itself. So in both the cases we are getting minus 2 and hence it is verified. So another representation is that alpha into beta, which is equal to c by a. What is c now? C we have got as 0 and denominator whatever it is 4, okay, we'll get it as 0 itself. How to verify this? Alpha however we have got as 0 and beta we have got as minus 2. 0 into any number we have 0 itself. So 0 into minus 2 we'll get it as 0 itself. And hence in these two cases it is same. Therefore it is verified. Now we have fifth problem given as t square minus 15. So how will you solve this? It's very simple. To find the zeros of the polynomial, so we'll make this polynomial equal to 0 itself. We'll get t square equal to 15. So taking square root on the both the sides, we'll get t equal to plus or minus root 15. Why plus or minus is because if we square minus root 15, we will get it as 15 itself. And if we square plus root 15, we will get it as 15 itself. Therefore, we can write it as t equal to plus or minus root 15. So, we have t equal to plus root 15 and t equal to minus root 15. Therefore, plus root 15 and minus root 15 are the zeros of the polynomial t square minus 15. Now, to verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients, we have alpha plus beta, which is equal to minus b by a, where we have b equal to 0, where first we will write it in the generalized form, ax square plus bx plus c. We have a equal to 1, b equal to 0 and c equal to minus 15. Here alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. B we have 0. 0 by a is 1, which is equal to 0 itself. To verify this, alpha plus beta, alpha we have plus root 15 and beta we have minus root 15. So plus root 15 minus root 15 is however equal to 0 and hence it is verified. Now another relationship, you have alpha into beta h is equal to c by a. From this we have got 1 minus 15 by 1 is minus 15 itself. To verify this, alpha into beta will multiply root 15 into minus root 15. So multiplying root 15 and root 15, we will get it as 15 itself, and minus is left over here, minus 15, and hence these both are same, hence it is verified. So friends, sixth question, that is 3x square minus x minus 4, is very simple. So I would like you only to do this problem, and I will be giving the solution for this problem in the next video. Now moving on to the second main question of exercise 2.2, it is given that to find a quadratic polynomial, each with the given numbers as the sum and the product of its zeros respectively. So in the first question, they have given 1 by 4 and minus 1. So they have given in the question that the following are the sum of the zeros and the product of the zeros respectively. It means sum of the zeros, alpha plus beta is 1 by 4, and the product of the zeros, alpha into beta, which is equal to minus 1. What we need to find out is the quadratic polynomial. So quadratic polynomial will be in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. We know that. So from the relationship we know that alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. So we can find it out. What is minus b by a? It is given as 1 by 4. And the product of the zeros, alpha into beta, is c by a. The relationship is c by a. And we have it as minus 1. So now what to do? Here it is minus b by a, and here it is c by a. So in this we have got a is 4, and here we don't have anything. So I would like to multiply numerator and denominator by 4. So we will get it as minus 4 by 4. So now we got a as 4 in both the relations. Therefore we can conclude that a is equal to 4. And b is equal to we have got minus b equal to 1. Therefore b is equal to minus 1, and c we have got as minus 4. So from this a, b and c values, we can write the quadratic equation. So the quadratic equation will become 4x square minus x plus, no, not plus, minus 4. This is the required quadratic polynomial. Moving on to the second problem, we have got root 2 and 1 by 3. So from the question it is given that the sum of the zeros is equal to root 2, and the product of the zeros, alpha into beta, equal to 1 by 3. So from the relationship we know that alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a. Minus b by a is given as root 2 itself. And from the another relation, alpha into beta is given as c by a, which is equal to 1 by 3. So in this case, a is equal to 3. Here we don't have a equal to 3. What we have to do? We have to multiply both the numerator and denominator by 3. So by doing this, we will get denominator as 3 here also and denominator 3 here also. So therefore, here we will get it as 3 root 2 by 3. Here we got it as 1 by 3. So from both these relationship, we have a equal to 3 and b we have got as minus b is 3 root 2. Therefore, b equal to minus 3 root 2. And the floor is c equal to 1. So from a, b and c, we can find out the quadratic polynomial, which is given by ax square plus bx plus c. So ax square means 3x square plus bx, no? B is minus 3 root 2. 3 root 2 x plus c. Plus c is 1. So this is the required quadratic polynomial. Now moving on to the third problem, we have got it as 0 and root 5. So given in the question that sum of the zeros alpha plus beta is 0 and the product of the zeros alpha into beta is root 5. So from the relationship we know that alpha plus beta equal to minus b by a, which is equal to 0, and from the relation alpha into beta is given by c by a, which is equal to root 5 by 1. Here a is equal to 1. Here we have got it as 0. 0 by any number is 0. So here we will assume it as 1. So in both the case we will get a as 1. Therefore a equal to 1. Minus b is 0, therefore b is also equal to 0, and c we have got it as a root 5. C equal to root 5. Therefore our quadratic equation will be ax square plus bx plus c. Ax square is 1x square, we can directly write it as x square, plus bx. Bx is 0. 0 into x is 0 itself, so no need to write that. And we have got c as a constant. What is c? C is root 5 plus root 5. Therefore it is the required quadratic polynomial. So my friends, I am sure that you can solve the next three problems also, and I will be directly giving the solutions for the next three questions. It is 1, 1, minus 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 and 4, 1. So we will be meeting in the next video where we will solve exercise 2.3 and we will learn to divide the polynomials. Friends, if you have any doubts, put it in the comment box and I will try to reply as soon as possible. If you have any doubts on how to do factorization, find the link in the description given below where I have explained how to do factorization of quadratic polynomial both by using formula and splitting the middle term. If you have enjoyed the session, please hit a like button and subscribe to get the updates and share it to your friends, which may help them also. Thank you.